this video is going to be slightly different to all the others that I make. It's not going to be an educational bit of content. It's going to be basically like an update to me and the channel. And primarily, it's going to be about talking about memberships for this thing. So if you're not interested in that, don't bother watching. But if you're interested in what kind of business things I'm doing, then stick around. And also, at the end of this video, I'm going to be announcing what next week's video is going to be. And it's a doozy. It's a good one. So maybe you want to stick around for that. So I really like creating content. I like coming up with an idea. I like figuring out how to talk about that idea. I enjoy the script writing process, the editing process. I enjoy exporting it for you guys to watch. I enjoy the instant feedback that you have. I really enjoy the community aspect of it. And also from an egotistical point of view, I like being the center of attention. I am very narcissistic, not in terms of the way I look, obviously, but just in my general persona. I keep it under wraps quite well, but yeah, it's still there. I think the reason I like doing content creation is because it reminds me very heavily of being a teacher. So when I was doing my undergraduate degree, or even in college a little bit, college and university, I was training to be a teacher. And sometimes I'd have to come up with a way to explain a very complicated idea to a classroom of students. And I'd deliver that concept the way that I would feel was good. And the community of students in that classroom would give me feedback instantly, either explicitly or implicitly. They'd feedback to me about how successful I was. And I really enjoyed that process. I didn't become a teacher because I don't particularly agree with the school system. I've been making content on YouTube for about over 13 years now. I'm coming up to 14 years. And I've never once had a sponsored video. I've never once been paid to say something. This episode is sponsored by Skillshare. Never once. I've always found my own way of providing value to the channel. I either had a full-time job whilst doing YouTube. I either had a part-time job whilst doing YouTube. I either had stipend or maintenance or student loans or something like that as being part of an educational program. Or I've been self-employed, or even now I run my own company. And the reason I've always paid for myself is because I feel very uncomfortable asking for money. I really do. I don't know why. Good money is good money. But recently I've been really reflecting on things in my life. And one of those things is opening up channel memberships. I feel like there's three different types of people. There's those who wallow in the past, and because they're wallowing in the past, they don't think about their future, nor do they act now to impact their future. Then you've got those who idealize about what their future could be, and they think about it so much, they don't actually do anything about it. And then there's people like me who do not wallow in the past. They don't idealize about the future. They just do whatever they want during the now. And I've come to realize that for me and my goals, it's not really the best form. I should be reflecting on what I've done in the past, idealizing about what I would like to do in the future, and setting goals so that I can execute that now. What my goals are, I'm not going to get into it in this video, but one thing that keeps on coming up time and time again is YouTube or content creation. I feel like I want to be a full-time content creator. I genuinely do. But how do I achieve that? Well, as I said, reflecting on what I've done in the past, idealizing about what I would like to do in the future. I've set up like a roadmap of things to do. Making content was one of those things. Creating channel memberships is another one of those things. And there are other things in the future that I'm going to be doing to help push me towards that goal. And the pandemic has really opened me up to even more reflection about the possibilities of doing stuff like that. So, as I've said many times, I've opened up channel memberships again. A channel membership is kind of like a subscription. So if you have like Netflix or Amazon Prime, it's very similar to that. You pay a monthly subscription in return for some value. And a little bit of backstory, I used to have a very successful Patreon page where people would subscribe to my Patreon page financially, and I would produce content for them, or I'd give them personal coaching or advice or live streams, or I had a podcast on there as well. I had loads of different things exclusive to my Patreon page. I had a lot of dropped subscriptions on Patreon. And one thing that I noticed was that when somebody exits the subscription on Patreon, they can write why they left. And a lot of people were saying that they left because they didn't agree with the way that Patreon acted. And I would agree with that, which is why I left Patreon. I probably earned, considering I had a full-time job at the time, I probably earned about a week's worth of wages-ish, less usually, every month, which was really good. And a lot of the reasons why my YouTube channel was so good at the time was because of this supplement of income. In fact, I was able to quit my full-time job at one point. I just worked 2 days a week in a shop, and the rest was online business. YouTube have really caught up with what I want a platform to do. They offer video uploading, obviously. They offer very good live streaming. I think the live streaming on YouTube is going to be better than Twitch and every other platform soon for 2021. They offer music publishing. They offer now memberships like Patreon did. They offer donations. They can offer apparel or merchandise buttons for content creators. And they offer social media posting now, all in the same platform. And the reason I kept on practicing different things from different platforms is because I wanted to diversify what I do online. Don't put too many eggs in one basket. But I realize now that that's not really the best way to go, for me at least. Like, obviously, from an entrepreneurial standpoint, diversifying is the key. But from a personal standpoint, I really struggle with trying to come up with a motivation to so many different sources of content. What I need is, instead of fanning out my efforts, I concentrate into one. And then over time, I open up the fan a little bit. And as I've said, I think I've said it in this video, I've always felt very uncomfortable asking for my audience for money. But times have changed recently with how people act around subscription-based platforms and content and such like that. So, if you like me or you like what I do and you are financially able to and you financially want to be a member, then please do so. I have 3 tiers of memberships for offer: Layer 0, Layer 1, and Layer 2. There's a theme. Can you pick out the theme? And the way that memberships tiers work is that if you have a higher tier, you get everything underneath it. So layer 2 is a higher tier, the highest tier I offer, you get layer 1 and layer 0. If you have layer 1, you also get layer 0. If you have layer 0, you don't get the stuff above. So let's talk about it. Layer 0 is the cheapest one I have, which is $1.99 a month, which is the price of a loaf of bread and a jug of milk, which means you'll get access to emojis for live streaming. You also get access to a channel membership badge so everyone can see that you're a member, but you also get access to members only live streams every single week. So every week on Sundays, I'm going to be doing a live stream. I'm really looking forward to doing, so I love doing live streams, but it'll be open to everyone in the public. But then when the live stream has ended, there will be a members only exclusive live stream following it. Layer 1, which is $2.99 a month, which is the same price as one of the cheapest 6-inch subs at Subway, you get access to exclusive content. So I'm going to be asking if anybody has any questions to ask me, and I will answer that in the form of a video. Now, depending on how complicated the question is, it could be 10 seconds long or it could be 10 minutes long. But if you have a question to ask and I feel like it's appropriate to answer it, it could be about lucid dreaming. It could be about health and fitness, because I have a degree in that. It could be about business and entrepreneurship, because I have a master's degree in that. It could be things about myself. It could be things like life advice about you, which I've been told I'm pretty good at giving life advice. I hope that's true. So you'll get access to all of the exclusive videos, questions from all the different members. I think after a while, I'll probably compile those into a compilation of some kind and release it to my YouTube channel. But for the time being, only members will be able to see it. So layer 2, which is $4.99 a month, which is the same price as a pumpkin spice latte, you'll get early access to all the content I produce on YouTube. So it could be a day before, it could be a week, it could be a month before, but no matter what, you'll get early access. You'll be the first to see the content before anyone else does. As I said, I've felt and still feel very uncomfortable asking for money. even though I'm offering a service in exchange. However, my master's in entrepreneurship is screaming at me that I'm missing an opportunity, because if 1% of my audience is a member at the lowest tier, then it will pay for all of my bills and rent after YouTube have taken their split of the revenue. It's mental. If less than 0.5% of you are members at the $4.99 tier, then it does the same thing. If I get 1% of people at $4.99 a month, I would be on incredible money. Not offering a membership to my channel would be silly, I think. Just as long as what I provide in terms of value is worth the money that you provide, which I think I've kind of nailed. I kept the cost quite low, but also kept the value quite high, I think. So that's the channel memberships done. Now, I teased a video for next week. Next week's video is a really good one. It's going to be called Lucid Dreamer Reacts to Inception. And it's going to be me sitting down, picking out different scenes of Inception and analyzing it and breaking it down to what is accurate information, what is not accurate information, what's realistically achievable, what's not achievable and just fictional for the film. And hopefully it will really resonate with you. I really love Inception. It's my favorite film. So if you want to stick around and watch that video, it will be released next week. However, if you want to see it earlier than usual, it's live right now to members only of the $4.99/layer 2 tier. So consider that. That's some excellent channel membership bait right there. So this video is a lot different to the rest that I post. There's no fancy editing. It's quite long, actually. But it's just me talking about how I see the future a little bit and offering and showing you what I offer in terms of value for subscription. So yeah, that's that. Long video. So yeah. Bada bada. I can't really remember what day it is today. I think it's Wednesday. I'll see you on Friday. Bye.